Hi everyone, and in today's video I'm going to be doing Pac-Man frog care. So I'm going to talk about cage setup, feeding, temperatures, all that sorts of stuff. So the first is going to be setup, and for these guys it's pretty basic. You don't want anything too crazy, they don't move around a whole lot. So you can go with something simple like I have. This is just a, I think it's like a 12 quart just plastic tub. I got it at like my local just department store, and it's really cheap and it's a great solution. All I did was drill holes in the side. They're kind of hard to see because of the background, but I drilled like between like 5 or 6 holes down each side for ventilation. You don't want to ventilate these tubs too much because you want to keep humidity up. Pac-Man frogs love humidity, so high humidity is very important. You can see the condensation on the side. They take in most of their water and things like that right through their skin. They don't necessarily drink from a bowl. You can leave a bowl in there. Usually he does have a water bowl. I just took it out for the purpose of the video, but usually he does have a water bowl. I've never seen him drink out of it. I've never even really seen him use it, but it's a good option to have in there for them, just in case they may decide to use it. While I'm on the topic of water, you want to dechlorinate the water for Pac-Man frogs and most other frogs too, because it can be harmful to their skin. So you can either get the like bottled conditioner from like a pet store or a reptile store that'll take out any kind of dangerous things that are in the water. You can also use bottled water. Some people say if you leave water out over a certain amount of time, then it's safe. It's really just up to you. The safest bet is either bottled water or just using the dechlorinator that is made specifically for reptiles. But either way, you just want to make sure you're not using too much tap water on them. So for substrate, I have what's called forest floor. I think it's by like Zilla. It's basically a mixture of like peat moss, coconut fiber, and a few other things. I also have some sphagnum moss. It's kind of hard to see, but the sphagnum moss is all over here, and he's kind of moved it over here as well. And these are good substrates for keeping humidity, but the most basic bedding is just coconut fiber. Just it comes in like the brick form, or you can get it in the loose form as well. I didn't have any on hand when I got him at the time, so I just simply had forest floor, so that's what works. It doesn't have any bark or anything in it, so it worked out well, and he's been doing just fine in it. You're basically just going to want a bedding that holds humidity well, so most people just go with some kind of coconut fiber substrate, and that seems to work the best. You don't want to use anything like cypress mulch or like aspen or anything like that. Those are all bad. They don't, like cypress mulch, the particles are just a little bit too big. They can't really get themselves buried in it. And aspen, of course, does not hold humidity, so that's a very bad substrate. It'll just get moldy, and so definitely don't use that. For temperatures, you're going to want to keep these guys at around room temperature, so generally in the 70s is like the ideal, but between 65 to 85 degrees will work. For diet, they can eat a pretty varied diet of different bugs like mealworms, crickets, roaches, and other assorted things like that, as well as small mice. Depending on the size of your Pac-Man, they usually can take a pinky mouse, which is basically just like a newborn mouse. And I feed this guy a pinky mouse a couple times a month, and weekly I feed him crickets, superworms, the occasional hornworm, which are those green worms, and whatever other bugs I'm getting for my other reptiles. He'll pretty much eat all of them. And you're going to want to dust them with some sort of reptile calcium. And this is the one I've been using. It's RepCal with vitamin D3. You can also use a multivitamin supplement every now and then, but this is the one I use most often. I use it once a week maybe, sometimes less, sometimes more, just depending on how much I'm feeding him. But this just helps to make sure that he's growing well, because my little guy down here is only a few months old. So now I'm going to be feeding him a few of these superworms. Males usually get between 2.5 inches to 4 inches, where females can get all the way up to 7 inches. These frogs generally, like most frogs, do not like handling. So any sort of handling is usually not tolerated. They can be quite bitey because they're gonna think your fingers are food. So handling is definitely not recommended with these guys. Handling is stressful and can damage their skin and that kind of thing. So they're more of a look, don't touch kind of pet. So if you're looking for a pet that you'll be able to handle and touch a lot, these guys probably aren't for you. But if you're looking for a pet that you can watch feed, and they're pretty dramatic feeders, they love to eat, and they're really, really simple, then these guys definitely would be for you. The maintenance on these guys is usually pretty simple. I feed my Pac-Man frog Jabba here, who is about 6 months old, 2 to 3 times a week depending on what I've fed him. If I feed him a pinky mouse one of the days, I usually only feed him twice, but if I only feed him insects that week, I'll feed him 3 times. Younger Pac-Man frogs can be fed every other day, and older Pac-Man frogs can be fed once or twice a week. It just depends on how much food you give them at once, and also on temperature for digestion, and that sort of thing will kind of have to tell you how often you should be feeding. So overall, Pac-Man frogs make really great pets. They're really easy, they don't require a lot, they don't require any special heating or lighting if your house is within general room temperature guidelines, and they eat really easy things, as well as they're really fun to watch eating. It's awesome to watch them get the bugs and take down the pinky mice. It's really cool. And they also come in really bright colors. Like here, mine is an albino. He's really, really pretty. And they also come in like a more of a reddish strawberry color. They come in lime. They come in green, which would be your normal Pac-Man, and many more. So they're really quite great if you want like a bright colored pet as well. So yeah, that's just about everything you have to think about when you are deciding if a Pac-Man frog is right for you. So if you like this video, give it a like, and if you want to see more videos from me, definitely subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!